Hello, hello! VideoGaming Father is here to invite you to the video review of fast-paced arcade racing game with retro visuals called Hotshot Racing. Will you find there good old arcade fun like in the arcade racing games from the 90s? Does it also bring something new or just revamp the old gameplay? Will you race against challenging opponents on the variable and well-designed tracks? Isn't the game ruined by clunky controls? Is there any career in the game or just a set of anonymous races? If you keep watching, I can promise you to give you useful information whether this game is worth your attention or you should just look somewhere else. I usually start with a story. But here we have an arcade racing game, so what story is he talking about? You're probably thinking right now. You would be surprised, but you will find something like story even here. Well, I'm saying something like, because it's a very little story. There are 8 different drivers in the game that you can choose from, and each driver is represented by a different character with his own background affecting their behavior. For example, one is a typical casual American, while another one is conservative British aristocrat. Based on their character, they comment on the events on the track in different ways, and they also have their own outro after finishing Grand Prix. Well, do not expect something too sophisticated, but this pleasant detail that gives the game characters some depth and makes you try all of them to have a different experience every time. But let's leave the story part and let's focus on the most important part, the gameplay. I have played the Grand Prix mode, where there are 5 Grand Prix and each of them consists of 4 tracks. Before each Grand Prix, you select your driver, the car for him or her, and get directly to the race. From the first moments, it's clear that Hotshot Racing is a typical arcade racing game. There are a lot of collisions with other drivers from the start of each race, there is a clock ticking measuring the remaining seconds that you have to go through the next checkpoint, and you almost never use the brakes. But there is nothing wrong with it if it's funny enough. And I would not expect lover of hyper-realistic simulations to play this game anyway. So, you put the finger on the gas button and release it only in some corners and sometimes even use the brake to drift through them. By drifting you are also charging nitro, which might be very useful especially in the finish line. Your opponents are pretty aggressive, so you can expect only the worst from them. And quite often you have a feeling like you are in some kind of destruction derby rather than normal race. Luckily the cars are indestructible, so you will just lose some time if you hit the wall rather than the whole race. The well-known and not very popular rubber band effect is used here, so you are never able to outrun your opponent so much that you would lose contact with them for the rest of the race. I cannot say that I am a big fan of it, but here I didn't mind so much because it makes each race pretty exciting. And you will feel a wave of adrenaline every time you overtake 2 competitors just a couple of meters before the finish. Hotshot Racing is also one of those racing games where you really feel the speed of your car, so you need to be heavily focused all time long. On the other hand, this rubber band effect degrades car statistics a little bit. Each car is defined by its speeds, acceleration and drift. But even if you have the fastest car, you can bet that your opponents will stick with you closely. So it's up to your preference, but if you like adrenaline rush till the very end, you will enjoy it. Now let's take a look at cars and tracks. Each driver has 4 cars to choose from. Although you will not find real brands here, you will probably recognize the real templates. You can choose any car from the very beginning, so you are not unlocking them for medal positions, unlike in many other racing games. There are also no real upgrades that you can buy for money earned in races, only cosmetic stuff. Along with the fact that the car statistics are not so important due to the rubber band effect, the game does not really motivate you to earn money for new cars and their upgrades. On the other hand, tracks in the game are variable enough, and in each Grand Prix you will be racing in variable environments like Area 41, Amusement Park or Ocean World. There are a lot of small but atmospheric details around the track like UFOs, jumping orcas, waterfalls or spinning Ferris wheel. The tracks themselves are classic circuits with long straight parts where you can use the nitro and also the technical parts where you can test your drifting skills. In general, I was satisfied with the track design and their variability. How about the difficulty in game controls? I've played on normal difficulty and the game was not too difficult. The truth is that the opponents are very aggressive even on this difficulty, but the rubber band effect applies on you as well, so even if you make some mistake or are mercilessly brought down by your opponents, you still have a good chance to win. Almost every time I finish among the first three drivers, and in most of them I won, but I could never be sure about my win till the end of race, and sometimes I only took the lead on the finish line. Hotshot Racing is also one of those racing games where you really feel the speed, which requires fast reactions and provides a real adrenaline experience. The time limits to reach the next checkpoints are rather benevolent, so in general it's challenging yet not frustrating game. And if you need more challenges, you can just choose hard or expert mode. As for the controls, you just need the left and right button, gas, brake and nitro. The car reacts to your commands as you would expect in an arcade racing game, so it doesn't spoil the good racing experience at all. Cannot tell how it's on the keyboard, but on Xbox controller, which is actually recommended, the controls are very smooth. So Hotshot Racing succeeded in these important aspects, and now let's get to the audiovisuals. The game has low poly graphics, but definitely does not offend either your eyesight or any other senses. In general, the graphics are smooth, colorful, with a good level of detail, the cars and all other objects are easily recognizable, and thanks to the high resolution, it looks definitely better than the legendary arcade games from the 90s like the original Need for Speed or Screamer. As I said before, there are many small details around the track. There are almost no empty places, so there would be quite a lot of places that you could enjoy, if only the game was not so fast. But do not get me wrong, this is a plus for a good racing game. As for the sounds, they are okay for arcade racing games, and especially some comments produced by your driver can be really funny. And the game soundtrack really rocks, and dynamic racing music perfectly fits the game. The best thing is that it becomes even more dynamic and faster when you reach the final lap. It's a very good idea contributing to the adrenaline atmosphere. So, have devs on Hotshot Racing delivered us a good arcade racing game that could be compared to the legends of the genre? I would say yes. It has many pros like the atmosphere full of adrenaline, sense of speed, good track design with variable environment, challenging difficulty, responsive controls, nice graphics, grand soundtrack and something that I have not mentioned yet, tada, split-screen multiplayer for up to 4 players. On the negative side are the absence of proper career mode, low effect of car statistics, sometimes irritating rubber band effect and maybe the lack of innovation. Thanks to the simple controls and fairly set levels of difficulty, I can recommend the game for the whole family, especially with the local split-screen multiplayer. Hotshot Racing costs 20 euros on Steam, which is quite much, but it's often discounted by more than 50%, and for such price I can recommend it with a clear conscience. In general, I've been satisfied with the fun that Hotshot Racing delivered, and thus I'm giving it thumbs up, and VideoGaming Father's Index 8 out of 10. Recommend it. Thank you for spending your time by watching my video review. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumb up, and also subscribe to my VideoGaming Father's channel to be informed about my new video reviews. Hope to see you soon!